Mesquite Horn opened in 2000. 21 years later, Alejandro Villalva became the first cross-country runner to represent the school at the state meet.
To say that I'm part of Horn history, that's just cool in itself.
To say anyone saw this coming? That's just not true.
I used to be a little chubby.
He kept saying, what sport should I do? Because he wanted to do something. I said, what about cross country or track?
And if you would have told me back in here in Barrie that, hey, he's going to make state, he's going to qualify for a state meet, there's no way.
He started running in middle school, but he wasn't fast. In eighth grade, he finished dead last in a district race.
Pick it up, go, you guys, pick it up.
So I think each school had one representative. He finished last. I mean, it was by like, what, 40 seconds or something like that.
If you saw him out there, you'd have been, oh, poor kid. And I have no problem saying that because Alejandro can laugh at that. He can. He's like, but look at me now.
The coaches were like, we know you're not the best. You're not the like up there, but we can see something in you, you know?
Alejandro joined Coach Tammy McDew's program and did nothing to stand out. But the summer after his freshman year, 1 week in Canyon, Texas, made all the difference.
He went to a cross-country camp at West Texas A&M University, and that really, really made him really think, you know what, I really like this sport.
And to me, that was when I saw the major difference. When he came back from that camp, he was just a different athlete.
As a junior, Alejandro qualified for regionals and went to state, but as a spectator. His father bought a hat.
He asked, is that for me? And I said, well, it will be. As long as you come back next year, you qualify and you run at the state meet.
Behind the great runner is an entertainer.
She's been calling him our triple threat because not only is he a good runner, he's a good folklorical dancer. He's also in the choir.
Alejandro was an eighth grader when he sang that national anthem before a Barrie Middle School football game. He and his family have been part of a Mexican folkloric group that, before COVID, performed at community-oriented events 60 to 70 times a year.
There's a Spanish word that we use, it's called ganas, which is that drive, that push to succeed. You have to have ganas.
You have to have that grit. You have to have that grind. It's different than any other sport. It's special.
He talked about it even when he was a freshman, just because, you know, he saw other people, but he didn't think he would ever get there, though.
I would have never pegged him as making any kind of varsity team in any sport, you know, much less qualifying for a state meet. So that's like, it just goes to show you never need to count these kids out.
I would like to try to make it to the Olympics. That would be my dream, is to make it to the Olympics.
Don't count this kid out. Ted Madden for the Mesquite ISD.